I combined over 30 mods to make the ultimate nightmare realm in Minecraft. This is literally the creepiest place to exist. Everywhere you look, it's just lava, volcanoes, and a buttload of nasty creatures that want nothing more than to eat me alive. This guy right here, look at him. He will turn you into a pile of goo in a matter of seconds. There's even a mod that measures my sanity in this place, and as I get closer to that 100-day mark, things start to get really weird, and they just keep on getting weirder. There are several bosses here that are, well, very, very difficult to kill. I learned that the hard way. This place is crawling with all types of creatures. Some are microscopic, while others, absolutely massive. See this morn? Yeah. This guy is, oh, huh? Is that Beppo merch? No way! We got hoodies, hats, t-shirts, best of all. I'm picking a random person who buys my merch within the next 7 days of this video being released to join me and my friends in a good old-fashioned game of Task Race 2.0. Don't know what the heck that is? Check out my first video. It's on Task Race. As usual, this map is available for my Patreon supporters. Huge thanks to you guys. And I know what you're thinking, but no, all this stuff is automatically generated. So, like, I don't know where the loot is at. I don't know the ores. They're all spread out randomly. And I have no idea where anything is. Everything's completely randomized. And you know how I mentioned I was trapped? Well, the only way to get out of here is by defeating Herobrine. Yeah, so all I'm doing up to day 100 is preparing for the big showdown. The very first day, nay, the very first minute that I started out, I almost died. What is that? Oh no, now on fire. Oh man. Okay, I actually could die here. I have no clue how I'm supposed to survive this for 100 days. I don't even know if I can survive it for one day. Anyway, after that narrow escape, I noticed a tree across the lava river. Clearly, I needed wood, so I ran along the river until I found a means of getting across.
I don't know how I'm supposed to get across this lava lake. It's massive. Maybe if I go over there, or... Oh, it looks like the obsidian connects over there.
Negotiating the volcano, I slowly made my way down to reach the obsidian pathway. I stuck right past the angry floating tower thing and finally made it to the bridge. The second I made it across, I was welcomed by a few of the locals though. Unable to sprint, I stumbled around trying to follow the only sense of direction I had, a tree. Finally though, I made it and there was a whole forest of creepy dead trees. I was admiring the nice scenery when suddenly...
Dude, there's a house up there! Bro!
I knew the only way I could survive any longer was if I got to that house. On my way, I found a stray pig, and I wasn't gonna mess around. Instantly, I got to work by making a sword.
Die, Technoblade! What? Why is he fighting me back?
Okay, since when did pigs, or any friendly animal for that matter, attack you? I don't remember installing a mod that made pigs attack. I finally filled my belly, but not for long. Raw meat doesn't last. Also, it decreases my sanity levels. Finally, I made it to the house, but wait a second, this doesn't look right. The house I saw before was half broken. Eh, whatever. I didn't care. All I cared about was the fact that I found something, but compared to what happened next, that doesn't even matter.
Oh, what? Dude, I can't see any- They're coming for your soul, day 90?
They are coming for your soul. I have no idea what that's supposed to mean, but it's marked with day 90, so probably something's gonna happen on day 90. My next goal is to find sheep, because a bed was the most important thing in the world at this moment. However, I found something very different along the way.
Are these bone blocks? Is this a fossil? Am I on the world's biggest fossil? I can't even tell with how dusky it is out.
Yeah, about what I said, I never found any sheep. I'm completely dead. It was pitch dark, foggy as a smoker's lungs, and cold as ever. As I was running through the forest, each and every sound frightened me. I wasn't sure if I would last until day.
What was that? I just heard an explosion. What is that?
Yeah, that man down there somehow caused a massive explosion. I sprinted up the mountain with all my might. Eventually making it to the top, I saw that I was still being chased, so I pillared up as fast as I could. My only hope was that this thing couldn't climb walls. Once making it to the top, I had a 500 IQ genius idea. Since I couldn't see what was chasing me, I thought maybe if I threw blaze powder down at the man's feet, I could see him. Sure enough, it lit up a small area so I could see him, and I still have no idea what it was. All I could tell for sure is that it was a nerd. Whew, that was an insane first day. Wish I could say it stopped there, but that would be a bald-faced lie and I'd be a bald-headed liar. Instantly, I got jump-scared by a clown. I don't know why, but for some reason, I started speaking like a baby.
Oh, what was that? What the heck is that thing? Go!
I stumbled down the mountain and knew I was in desperate need of supplies, so I chopped down an entire tree. Just kidding, I just broke a few logs. You really thought I chopped down an entire tree? Anyway, I got some stone, made some tools, and found a wall. Yeah, not the most exciting 5 seconds, but just wait. I found some sort of fallen meteor that looked like it had crashed recently. Luckily, there was a little bit of iron in the crash site, so I mined and smelted it to make a bucket. Now, I know what you're thinking, and the answer is no. I didn't make the bucket because there wasn't a toilet. I actually made it to start a farm with the few seeds that I had found. I kept running around trying to find water, but to be honest, at this point I was kind of doubtful that any water even existed in this world. Suddenly, I found something incredible. No, not the water, you idiot. Mushrooms. Man, I was so glad I finally had a bed. I never wanted to spend another night running through a forest full of fog while mildly constipated. Forgot that I wrote that. For the rest of day 2, I just ran around looking for water when eventually I went to bed. Day 3, I literally spent looking for water. I never found any. Oh, but this happened.
I found it's super foggy down there. I'm not even sure what I'm looking at, but it looks like clay for a second.
Now, I know what everyone's thinking, no, this is not cheating. Blowing up in my bed was never supposed to be a part of this. Beds are supposed to work just completely normal. So let's just say I had an explosive night and I never died. I think the reason that I blew up that time but not the other times was because the biome is literally the nether biome in some places. So when I slept before, it was in a different biome that wasn't the nether biome. And last time it was, maybe? Anyway, check it out, water. I couldn't believe my eyes. However, there's always a downside. About 15 of those little buggers were just chilling down there in the swampy clay, waiting for some simpleton such as me to walk down there. So, you know what I did, guys. I walked down there. Yeah, I told you I was a simpleton, okay? It wasn't that bad. I got in and out pretty quick, actually, but as I was coming out, I noticed another massive skull. Right then, I decided it should be my home. I named this buddy Jeff. First day in my house and I was already treated by visitors. Who had any idea it was so rough living in hell? Not me. Not me. Okay, what is this guy? Pepe the Frog? Seriously, I'm like 83% sure that's Pepe. Had no idea Pepe died and came here to join me. Anyway, I tricked the creeper into exploding them all so I could get a clean getaway. Or at least, that's how it went down in my mind. With that, day 4 concluded, so I hit the sack.
Well, I tried to hit the sack. Every time I did, this weird demon would spawn and try to assassinate me.
What the heck is this? What is that? Get out of here. Why can't I sleep? What the heck is this?
Eventually, I was able to sleep, though. Day 5, I finally traveled back into the forest in order to get dirt. I needed it for a farm because if I didn't start growing crops ASAP, I was toast. I made it back to my base and finally got to work on my farm. If I hadn't have gotten this farm now, I would be completely dead later on, and you'll see why. The next day went by just as fast as the last. I went back into the woods to collect wood. I chopped down a tree for about half the day, and for the rest of day 6, I spent farming. Man, I sure am glad I found this fossil. The bone blocks are craftable into bone meal, and it's so great being able to instantly grow my crops. My farm was pretty good, but it wasn't enough for me to live off of it, so I needed to expand it, so I gathered up more dirt. I then added some wood to the farm to try to make it look nice, but that didn't work. Oh yeah, I also had a really close encounter with a green boy.
Oh, oh, oh!
After that, I decided that I needed to up the defenses, so I crafted some wood fences and placed them all around the skull. Hopefully that will deter any idiots from coming up here. If that creeper the day before would have done half a heart more damage, I'd be dead right now and you wouldn't be watching this. Because of this, I realized that I desperately needed protection. So I was getting ready to bake some bread when suddenly a fireball grazed my nose.
One shot. Come on. Yes! Oh, let's go. That was great.
Heck yeah, that was awesome. Okay, anyway, I gotta go mining. Look at this. I dug straight into a cave with a creepy dude on a lava monster. Suddenly, the creeper just randomly exploded on me and knocked me right down into the cave. I was not having it, so I boxed myself in like a fish. Mining down some more, I came to a sudden realization.
Oh, and I used up all of my wood for torches. How dumb can I get?
I couldn't craft ladders, so I decided to build myself out. As soon as I got out, it was night, so I slept. Day 9, I started out by lighting up my base so that mobs couldn't spawn. Clearly, it didn't work because, well, I mean, you can just see.
Hey, dude, how'd this catch on fire? Oh, there's a creeper. No!
Right after that, I noticed I was bone dry on wood, so I went back into the forest once again. All right, day 10, here we are. Well, I still needed armor, so I finally went on that mining trip. I found some iron and a pretty sketchy cave. I lit up the cave and it was good, nothing killing me. Boom, check it out, got some iron armor, finally. Okay, the rest of today could have gone way worse. You see that? Yeah, that's a blood moon. This means that not only can I not sleep through the night, but nearly 5 times the amount of mobs spawn. 5 times. I can barely survive with 1 times. Anyway, it wasn't actually that bad because I was mining, so as long as I stayed out of the caves, I would hopefully be okay. I did, however, go into a cave anyway. It was a small cave, so just a few magma monsters in there. Not a big deal. Oh man, check this out. Diamonds. Heck yeah. I couldn't believe my eyes seeing those shiny blue rocks. I got 8 from a single vein. Day 11, I was still mining. In fact, I mined straight into a lava monster.
Whoa.
Look at this, guys. I found a cave with the most incredible amount of diamonds I've ever seen. I promise, I'm not cheating. They're actually here. You can go in this cave and find these diamonds if you download the map. I can't believe it. There's like a billion diamonds here. I don't know. It's really weird. Finally, on day 12, I had accumulated 25 diamonds and decided that I was finally prepared to face some real challenges. I wanted to check out the world a little first, so I climbed all the way up the massive volcano to check out this view. Absolutely incredible. You know, my current base is actually pretty trash, and I should make something a little more defense heavy if I plan to survive any longer. I decided on the small plateau below the volcano to build my base. I made a buttload of cobblestone walls and started placing and placing and placing. Finally though, I finished and got this massive wall around me. Of course I had to light it up so mobs wouldn't spawn inside, and I started out with a very calculated approach, but that was slow, boring, and downright nerdy, so I decided just to spam torches down everywhere. Day 14, I spent all of relocating my base to the new area. The next day I worked on constructing my brand new farm. While building the farm, a stupid idiot decided it would be funny to shoot my farm with a fireball, and it ended up burning down a little bit. Now that I think about it, actually, I think that I'm the idiot here for building it out of wood on top of a volcano. Only problem was I couldn't kill him because there was a creeper right next to him and I didn't have a bow. To solve this problem, I decided to use an ancient technique that I learned from Sun Tzu. When confronted by an enemy with overwhelming force, simply run away until that nerd despawns. The place I had chosen to make my base definitely was not optimal because I had to flatten it out a little just so I could build a base. But in the process, a blood moon decided to be a funny man and rise.
No! No.
I thought, however, because of the wall, I would be okay, but these stupid creepers found a way past the immigration law. They decided to spawn inside the wall.
But Joe, how did those green boys spawn with all those torches here?
Well, fellow numbnut, torches don't stop zombie pigmen from spawning, and for whatever reason, creepers can spawn on top of their heads, so you do the math. For the rest of the night, I chose to play chicken and chill atop a small tower, and it worked. By the time it was day, I started cleaning up a bit of the carnage. The previous night, MagmaMonsters would shoot me nonstop, and creepers would even blow up the wall, so I decided to double up the wall and make it twice as tall. Maybe this way the creepers won't be able to see me and blow up my wall. I got tired of doing all that boring nonsense, so I decided to go exploring. Now, there's some pretty dope stuff in this world, and I knew that, so I went out to find said dope stuff. Check it out, right next door there's a nethery biome. Looks good to me! As soon as I made it across the lava river, I noticed these spire things with cobwebs on them. Cobwebs equal string, and string equal bow, so you know I got all up in that.
Oh, they're everywhere. There are so many. It's literally... Ah! Yeah, that's right. You better turn to obsidian.
Whew, those magma idiots almost killed me. Anyway, after shredding their lava bones, I decided to enter the Joker Tower thingy.
Is there a secret path? What the heck? Okay. Okay, it goes down. There's chests down there. No way. Oh! Pressure points! Oh, no! No!
Yeah, I cannot believe I fell for that. It's literally the most obvious thing ever. Everyone knows that desert temples have those traps. Also, how did I not see the pressure plates? I'm so mad. There could have been some really good stuff in there, and now I'll never know. Well, whatever. I kept moving forward, and, why are there pillars just chilling here in the middle of nowhere? After a quick nap, I decided to investigate.
No way! There's a chest up there. There's literally a chest up there. All right! Hey! I'm not complaining.
I honestly did not expect there to be good loot at the top of this pillar. It did, however, get me curious about the other pillars, though.
There's a chest in that one, too. Okay. Hopefully it has good loot. I mean, more bread. I'm happy with that. That one doesn't look like it has a chest either. Oh, it might have just been these two. Oh, that would suck. Oh, I want more chests. Yeah, I don't see any chests on this one. Oh, that one's got a chest right up there.
Wow, that was incredible. Three of the four pillars had chests.
A saddle and a single arrow. Okay.
Actually, looking back at it now, I bet that other pillar had a chest too. I should have looked harder. But hey, I'm not complaining. I got some epic gear from that. I was feeling good when I began to head back when I noticed some form of Stonehenge or something. Well, I got there and it wasn't anything special. So a creeper decided he wanted to become my friend and, he did. I started off day 18 with a little bit of farming. Then for some reason, I decided to go into the forest that I stumbled into on day one. I honestly don't remember at all why I went back there again, especially since it's so crazy dangerous, but whatever. Oh, that's right. Alright, I was looking for animals. I wanted to start eating something besides bread because with the insanity mod installed, it's bad for my insanity levels to eat the same food over and over again. Or at least, I think it is. Eventually, I ran straight into a brand new biome that I had not explored yet. Very volcano-y though. And I almost died from another creeper. These guys are tough because they don't slowly explode like normal creepers. Half the time, they just instantly explode when they are close enough to kill you. Makes it extremely difficult to fight them. The next day, I was still stumbling around this stupid biome when I noticed something that honestly kind of blew my mind. Yeah, this was insane. I could not believe it. I got like 16 diamonds, a buttload of cookies, books, saddles, gapples. Absolutely incredible. That's crazy. After collecting that unbelievable haul, I decided I should quit while I'm ahead and go back home and use the new materials I got. I didn't have nearly enough cobblestone to finish my double tall wall, so I used my new efficiency 5 pickaxe to absolutely shred the stone in the ground. After collecting cobble for a while, I made some walls and made some wall. Since I just made my sharp 4 sword, you know I had to test this baby out, so I went down to the river and found some unsuspecting nerds. And I must say, this sword cuts through these morons like butter. I even killed straight up Pepe the Frog. Anyway, the real reason I was down there was to collect clay for my horse. Nope, my house. Definitely not my horse. It's day 20 and I don't even have a house yet. Crazy. I made it back and boom, I got like 50 furnaces smelting up a million sacks of clay. The next day, I started work on the frame of the house. I wanted the house to be stylish yet capable of withstanding the harsh conditions of this nightmare realm. Soon, however, the furnaces had burned up all the coal in my supplies, so I ran over to the nether biome where I remembered seeing coal blocks. After a quick snatch of those little guys, I ran back in the evening. After finishing most of the base, I realized that I am a complete moron. I made the frame of this house out of wood. How did I not learn my lesson when the farm got fire? Anyway, I replaced the wood with obsidian. It actually didn't take very long to gather all that obsidian because of my efficiency 5 pick. Heck freaking yeah, look at that, that's awesome. All that was left for me to do was replace the floor, and I'm pretty sure my military grade compact house was complete. On day 24, I realized that the one thing my base was missing was a gate in the wall. I want an electric gate that automatically opens, and since I didn't have any redstone, I decided to go back to the mountaintop cabin that I found on day 1. You remember the one that had the secret room with the cryptic message? I'm still very scared for day 90, even with all the stuff. I made it and grabbed the piston and redstone. However, the only problem was there was only one piston. I needed at least 2, but preferably 4 sticky pistons, so I wasn't sure what to do about that. That night, I was stranded in the forest without a bed. This time, however, I had armor and weapons, so there was no way I was gonna die, right? Well, this time was, it was a little different. I found a few mobs that I didn't even know were in this game. Example 1, a clown. Also, what the heck is this thing?
Why is that thing slowly walking towards me while swaying? Oh, what the heck?
Okay, I have no idea what the heck that thing was, but the fact that it blinded me made it 100 times harder to kill. This was the day that I had my first encounter with, well, you'll just have to see for yourself.
Dude, this is kind of a cool place. It's like all soul sand. What happened here? Dude, this guy looks like he's missing an eye. Oh, he says no to that. He doesn't like it.
Okay, honestly, it was a bit easier to kill than I thought. Also, he may have not been at full health when I found him. Looked like his eye was missing. Kind of nasty. And I don't really know how he dropped his eye if it was missing, but I'm not complaining. Well, I still didn't have my bed because I'm an idiot, and I left it at home, so I had to travel all the way back to my base in the middle of the night. That night, I fought off all kinds of mobs of all shapes and sizes. Whew, finally, it's daytime. Man, that Jack the Ripper fellow dealt like half my health in a single blow while I'm in full diamond armor. Man's got a knife sharper than a razor blade. I was looking around to see if any mobs had dropped anything, and sure enough, I found this troll's hammer. I spent most of the day walking back to my base. I needed redstone to build a gate for my wall, so I went mining to find some. Either that, or I just needed cobblestone. Honestly, I don't remember. But hey, I found diamonds. A lot of them, actually. I think they can generate any Y level here. Oh no, another blood moon, and this time I wasn't stuck underground. Okay, well, actually I was underground, but I was getting ready to leave, so, you know. As soon as I made it out of the mine, I was greeted with a lovely charged creeper. I tried to kill him, but he was riding a baby zombie pigman, which had unbelievably quick legs for such little guys. He dodged all my arrows, so I retreated into the hut. Problem is, these creepers are a tad more evolved than the creepers that you're accustomed to. If these idiots can't reach me due to a wall, they'll just blow the wall right open. AKA, this madman might go full kamikaze and explode my house, just to make me suffer. I was trying to shoot down more creepies from my tactical bunker, but accidentally shot a pigman, and now all these morons are angry with me. Sneaking along my balcony, I used third-person view to try to find the charged creeper. I couldn't find him, so maybe the lava moat actually worked and and burn them up. But on the dark side, there was an army of pig dudes trying to poke me with their golden swords. I got on my roof, and for the rest of the night, I bowed down every clown I could find.
Oh no! No!
And that's exactly why I need a higher wall. Maybe then the creepers won't see me.
What was that? Dude, what? No, 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 no.
See, I told you these creepers will do literally anything to annoy me. In the morning, I came out to assess the damage. It wasn't pretty. Actually, it kind of was. Look at the way the lava shines so brightly. I still needed redstone or cobblestone. I still don't remember which I wanted, but either way, I started a new mine. Yep, I knew it. Cobblestone. See, I told you I was making walls. You guys never listen to me. I realized that after a night like that, I might need a bit more than a high fence, so I began constructing a moat, this time with water instead of lava. My hope was that creepers would come up to the wall, get stuck in the water, and when they explode, the wall would survive because of the water. Let's just say it didn't go exactly as planned, and well, you'll see why very, very soon. Once I finished the moat, I realized that even with all these torches all around my base and an entire wall, mobs are still getting in easily. That's due to a little thing I like to call zombie pigluridin. Or, as a simpleton such as yourself would say, zombie pigmen can spawn in any light level, and sometimes they spawn with straight up creepers on their heads, aka creepers can spawn at any light level now. To be concise, it was bad. So I widened up the lava moat around my house, hoping it would deter creepers from living before they could explode on Mikasa. You see this? Yeah, this is exactly why my water moat idea was a complete failure. These creepers only spawn riding these stupid idiots, and guess what? These stupid idiots float on water, so when the creepers explode, it's got not so much as a droplet of water on its furry skin. Luckily, I was able to kill it before it decided to go ballistic on my wall there. Oh, and guess what? That night, another blood moon rose. I hate my life. My only chance to keeping the wall alive at night was to either shoot the creepers dead before they had a chance to explode, or to shoot the magma monsters dead before they could make it to the water, so the creepers fell in the water. But then the most incredible thing that has ever happened to anyone in the history of the history itself happened. And it was to me, a straight up chicken jockey spawn. Do you know what this means? I can finally start a farm and eat some meat to regain my sanity. The more of the same food I eat, the more insane I go. And this whole time, all I've had is bread and cookies, so this was a miracle. Then I decided to take this time lapse of the moon as it went down. When I looked back at the wall, it had a great big hole in it. What? In the morning, I repaired it, and also, I could not find the miracle chicken baby anywhere. I think he must have burned alive in the lava. You must realize how sad this makes me. I even made a cage for him and everything, but there was still hope. I still owned 4 eggs from when I killed that creepy monster in the woods, and it split into a school of chickens. You remember that? Me neither, but I had eggs, so who cares? I threw one, nothing. Threw another, still nothing. I threw a third, and yes, I got one! Oh, wait. Hold on, that's 4 chickens compressed into one. That's right, that's a quad egg right there. These are extremely rare, and I bet most of you didn't even know that this was possible. This isn't from any of the mods that I have. This is actually just in vanilla Minecraft, and I got crazy lucky. Anyway, I didn't want any creepies to spawn inside my base, so I crafted up a couple of slabs and started placing. Pretty quickly, I ran out of cobblestone, so I mined some and placed some and mined some and placed them, and oh, time to sleep. For the next few days, I literally only mined and placed to try to eliminate any chances of mobs spawning inside my compound. Oh yeah, this really weird thing happened to me where I was just chilling inside my house when suddenly I got the nausea effect. I think it might be due to my sanity decreasing every day, or I don't know, but it was really weird. I kept placing slabs until halfway through day 31 when I realized I never actually finished my moat, so I got my buckets and started scooping. And for the next 2 days, I kept up with the same old mining and placing. Finally, I got tired of this and was close to complete, so I went into my house and realized that since pigmen can't spawn in the compound walls, the only place they can spawn is in my house. Clearly, I ain't having that, so I got to work immediately. The night of the 34th, I got back to my bed, and look at this. Man's T-posing atop my sleeping bag. Looks like a clown. Since I lowered the floor of my house by a half slab, I need more bricks so that it doesn't look like a dump. So that morning, I ran over to the clay supply so I could make it into bricks. While I was waiting for my bricks to smelt, I did a little bit of farming and noticed that I never changed the wood to stone in the farm, so this thing is still extremely susceptible to flames. Jump cut later and it looks a lot nicer. That night, I added in the brick slab so it no longer looks like I took a dump in here. Wait, no. It no longer looks like a dump in here. It's day 36 and my one and only chest is filled to the brim with a random assortment of items. I think it's mighty time I do a little something about this. I made some chests and bing bam boom, chest room complete. I spent the better part of the day relocating all my items. Later that day, I went to check on the chickens and I found a rotten egg. 2 of them, actually. I had no idea what the heck they did, but I was slightly afraid that they would hatch an evil chicken or something, so I threw the first one outside of my base. Turns out it sums in one of these cuddly little morons.
What? Is this? It's my new pet, I guess.
Oh man, then this happened. I was just minding my own business, hatching some eggs, when one of them happened to slip out of my hand and smack a chicken directly across its beak. I meant no harm, but these birds had no intention of caring. It went full on aggro. Oh yeah, and then I was mining some obsidian, and one of my stupid birds decided to commit death. So, that wasn't optimal. I felt a little safer knowing that my precious items were on the bunker above my house, but still, those stone brick walls are not all that hefty, so I decided to rebuild it out of obsidian. Ah, much better. It was finally time to construct the gate. Yeah, I didn't love how it turned out, especially since I only have access to a single sticky piston, but I'll take what I can get. At least it's functional. I also tried to saddle my bird, but unfortunately he would not cooperate. I added more water to the moat, but this time I made it flow from the walls. I'm hoping this forces the creepers to always be in contact with the water so that they can't blow up the wall. I basically just lined my entire wall with this stuff. No way these idiots are getting in here now. No way. I noticed that my bird kept on growing. He just kept on getting bigger and bigger. I hope he doesn't turn into a dragon at some point or something. Anyway, I tried to ride him again and nope, still wouldn't work. So for the rest of the day, I went back and finished the moat. I was so fed up with these mobs spawning like crazy every night. It was so annoying. So I kept on placing slabs throughout the base. And I also increased the height of the wall a lot. Later that day, I wanted to get some more dirt. So I went into the woods and suddenly I got jump scared by an Einstein or Frankenstein.
Whoa, what is that? What is that? Why is something running towards me? Oh!
Yeah, I don't know what that guy was all about. He looked creepy though. Anyway, I went back to dirt mining. I cut down some trees and look at this. This tree is straight up hollow. When I throw a torch down there, that just looks sick. Turns out I was cutting down trees a little bit too late because suddenly I realized that the sun was setting and look at that. Creeper blew up from like 40 blocks away. Stupid idiot. Oh yeah, look at this. I found a giant skeleton. Dude, I thought we were having a dance off or something because he started dancing a jig. I shot him a few times where the sun don't shine and he died pretty quickly. Oh, also check this out. Found a clown that was friendly. And then he wasn't for some reason. Oh yeah, and look at that. I found horses. I did not know that they would spawn in here. Anyway, I tried to tame one, but clearly he was working for the wrong side. One of the horses survived, so I took him, and look at that, he is fast. His name is Glub 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 Daduya. I found a numbnut while riding the horse, and the numbnut was a clown that dealt like 5 hearts with full diamond armor in one blow. I couldn't even hit him with arrows, but I did find his weakness. Blocks. Haha, sucker. Day 41, I was riding on Glub Glub Dadadoo. I don't even remember what I named him, some random letters. Anyway, when suddenly he just went right into lava and it's completely his fault. I had nothing to do with that. Completely his choice. Anyway, I dismounted to feed him so I could heal him up and he didn't want my handouts and decided to show me a magic trick, the vanishing act. I have no idea where he went. I never found my horse again after this. Look at this, I came back to the chickens and they finally forgave me. They decided not to kill me anymore. And look at that, I got another rotten egg, but nothing hatched from it when I threw it. Anyway, I mined some more cobblestone for slabs to finish my base. And look at this, I found dragon bones up here. I put this here, guys. There's a chest with the dragon bones, and there's like insane potions inside. Yeah, I'm as confused as you guys are, okay? Anyway, the chest included this immortality potion. Well, I mean, that's what I thought it said. It really said immorality potion, but you can't blame me for misreading it because the mod maker misspelled it anyway. Immorality has 2 M's, but I guess so does immortality. What does that even do? What would a potion of immorality? That doesn't make any sense. I think the mod maker just messed up. I also spotted a dragon like way off in the distance. I could zoom in and see him just barely. So I went in to investigate. After firing a couple shots, I went in for the hand to hand and just actually killed it pretty quickly. And look at that. I got its bones, a heart, some flesh or something. I don't know what they're used for, but they're kind of nasty. Anyway, I mined a lot more cobblestone and then I farmed and went to bed. It took all day, but I finally finished placing the slabs. The base inside is 100% mob proof now, or so I thought. My safety got me relaxed about security. Too relaxed for my own good, actually. I made the walls even higher, but unbeknownst to me, that would not be enough. Every time I jump in the chicken pit, they all attack me like crazy. Doesn't do any damage, but it really hurts the armor durability. The farm was not cutting out. I was so hungry. There was not nearly enough wheat in that thing, so I had to increase the size. Then I made even more walls to make my massive wall even higher. In some places, it's over 5 blocks tall. There's no way nothing's getting in here now. I kept running out of inventory space when chicken farming, so I made a chest for the chickens and way better. I don't know why I didn't do this on day one. My armor was almost completely dead. The durability was just dropping every time I went in the chicken pen, so I got some diamonds and repaired it. Later that day, I decided to go into the forest to find some new mobs. Actually, I think it was just to get dirt, but I ended up finding a lot of new mobs. I was too confident for my own good, actually, especially considering what was waiting for me in the woods. 10 seconds after leaving, a good example of my overconfidence. Creeper just about killed me and blew up the path in the process.
That was close.
Oh yeah, look at that. I discovered sheep. It was epic. I didn't even realize they existed here. Right after discovering them, I discovered something much darker.
Oh, I think this is where I was at before when I was... Herobrine? What?
Herobrine was here in these woods. I couldn't believe it. The man himself. Instantly, I ran away because I did not feel equipped to handle this bad boy. Then I remembered that I had a bow, so I was like, you know, I could maybe stay like 100 blocks away and just snipe him. So that's what I was trying to do. But it was actually a very difficult battle. Sometimes I was like destroying him, and then other points he was destroying me. I could never tell who was gonna win. The tables were constantly turning. Man, I almost died in that one point. I had to eat a notch apple, but I'm not regretting it because I would have died without it. You know, after that, the fight felt a little too easy, but I wasn't questioning it. Suddenly, I didn't even have to question it. He grew 50 times his own size. He could stomp on me dead in one step, so I just sprinted out of there and I was not coming back. I would fight him another day when I was a little more ready. I did meet some new creatures in the woods that night. Massive spider that poops out webs at 90 miles per hour, and this other mob that's really small, but really strong. Flies. I just wrote other mob small but strong, flies, shoots poison bolts. You guys can figure out what that means. I couldn't figure out if these mobs naturally spawned here or were summoned by Herobrine, but either way, I was out of there. I got lost on the way though, and I found myself in an endless obsidian field. I have no idea which direction was which. I found a lot more creatures though, some pretty spooky ones, like this little spidey thing, this humanoid ghost freak dude that is crazy strong. Average dude came up to me as well, very confused. Did he want to be friends or something? Was he trapped here just like me? Either way, I didn't care, and I shot him in the face. I ran all night long, and by morning, I finally made it back. As soon as I got home, I repaired my leggings. You know how before I said I repaired my armor? Well, I wasn't able to repair all of it because I didn't have quite enough XP, but now after that night, I had a ton of XP, so I was able to finally repair my leggings. Even with the wheat farm, I'm still super hungry, so I slaughtered chickens and got almost half a stack of chicken. Don't worry, I had leftover eggs and stuff to hatch new chicks, so it was fine. I also made this special chest solely for the purpose of preparing to fight Herobrine. Look at that! A creeper just exploded and did no damage because of the moat. That's sick. Oh yeah, also I took the screenshot of the compound. It looks awesome. I went on collecting lots and lots of lava. I had big plans for this stuff for the Herobrine fight. And for the rest of the day, I just mined stone. I discovered a brand new weapon, straight up half an obsidian sword. I wasn't able to craft it with an enchanted sword, so I had to make a brand new sword, but it does way more damage. This diamond sword with sharp 4 did 9.5 damage. The new one with no enchants does 19 damage. But you know what? Not good enough. I made the sword fully obsidian, now it has 25 attack damage. Says it was literally made to fight Herobrine. However, I don't think that's for phase 2. I think it's just for phase 1. I'm still not ready to fight phase 2 Herobrine yet. Oh yeah, and I discovered this brand new enchanted armor and twice enchanted armor that I can make from obsidian. I needed tons of obsidian for this though, so I mined 46 obsidian. I came up to the crafting table and look at that. I can't use my old diamond armor to craft the new obsidian armor because the durability was so low, so I had to repair it first. I wasted a lot of diamonds, but it's a lot cheaper than making a whole new set. Using like 30 diamonds plus the armor plus the diamonds used to repair the armor and almost a stack of obsidian, I made a full set of this enchanted armor. Wasn't good enough to fight Herobrine with yet though, just good enough for me to survive in this place a little longer. I added more obsidian to make it twice enchanted, and look at that, that looks incredible. Full set of armor gives me resistance, fire resistance, and regeneration. Now I was ready to fight him again. Alright, found Herobrine again. I potted up with strength and speed and started sniping him from a large distance. He tried spraying me with fireballs, but I shot them right back at him. Suddenly spawned an OP ghast right on me, but killed it instantly. Spawned another, killed it again. I thought this was actually a pretty easy fight, but he didn't like my insults, so he struck me with over 14,000 lightning bolts in like a split second. In order to stop his lightning strikes, I had to run away. I did this tons of times in order to keep my heart beating. The only thing keeping me alive was my armor, gapples, and potions. My bow was slowly breaking, and I couldn't keep shooting him forever. I had to go in for the hand-to-hand, David versus Goliath styles right now. Right before that, another baby version was summoned. Instantly, the phase 1 Herobrine just started sprinting towards me, and the big boy Herobrine summoned both lightning and OP ghasts on my face. I lured the baby one back so I could kill him before the big one took me down. I had to let him stab me multiple times so that I could kill the ghast, and my aim was dying with my bow durability. Things were not looking good. Soon, I found baby Brine's weakness, trees. You go behind a tree and there's nothing he can do about it. What a moron. Eventually, I killed him. Now for the big prize. Decided to chug what I thought was an invincibility potion, that way I could kill him and he could do nothing to me. Since I don't know how to read and it's not invincibility, I have no idea what this means, but it's too late. I had already drank it and was running towards the beast. I got some really powerful hits on him and he was slowly dying. Herobrine tried every trick he had, but I didn't care one bit. However, he wouldn't go down without a fight. I stepped back to use all the durability my bow could handle at the time. He was very low, so I went in for the final blow.
Ah! Oh! Fireballs everywhere. It's raining like crazy.
I did it. I killed Herobrine. No way. I was so happy. He was spinning out of control, going crazy. I went in to pick up whatever he dropped because I figured he had to drop something. And, well... Okay, guys, seriously though, this doesn't count. I thought I had killed him, so he can't kill me in a single explosion. I don't want to see any comments about this either. Uh-uh, that's not fair. That didn't happen. You saw absolutely nothing. I'm completely fine. What really happened here is Herobrine knocked me out cold. Later, I regained consciousness. Okay? When I eventually did wake up, it was raining, but I was so glad that I had finally rid the world of Herobrine. I was never going to see that ugly nincompoop ever again.
What? Whoa, there's more?
Wait, he's still alive. I could not believe it, so I ran away. Would the fight never end? I found insane gear, though, and other Brian must have dropped it right before he exploded. Okay, so I researched the mod a little bit. Phase 3 is the final form of Herobrine. I kill this one, and he really is gone for good. No more rematches, no more redos. It's over, as long as I can kill him. I wasn't even close to ready to taking him down now, though. I could barely take down phase 2, and phase 3 would shred me instantly. So I walked back in the rainy storm. Oh, I killed a clown that laughed at me after it died. I don't know how that works, but he was laughing at my failure, clearly. I wasn't sad, though. I knew once I could regain my strength and upgrade my armor, I would once and for all take Herobrine down for good. In the morning, I got a message that my bird died from a zombie pigman. I left the house to investigate, and look at that, wither bones on the ground where my bird was. I don't know what they do, but... Alright, I got revenge and killed the pigment. I looked up wither bones and there's all sorts of stuff on these. The most important thing was his dragon bone arrows, so I used my wither bones to make as many as I could, but first I had to repair my regular bow. I also made an armor stand for my old set of armor. It looks incredible. The rest of the daylight I used to mine 2 stacks of obsidian to upgrade my house for something very, very big coming very, very soon. I also found out that I'm an idiot because I can't use these arrows with a normal bow. The only bow I can use them with requires wither bones to make it, and I used up all of my wither bones to make the arrows, so I'm an idiot. Too bad my last bird died, otherwise I could have killed it for some more bones. I wanted more wither bones for the new bow, so I spent that night fighting mobs trying to get some. I never got a single one. While looking for a wither skeleton, I had to be careful not to get too close to Herobrine, otherwise I'd probably die instantly. My armor is good, but it could be a lot better. The next morning, the forest looked incredible. Just look at that orange glow. You know I had to take a couple screenshots. I take way too many screenshots. My folder has like 2,000 in them. As I was walking back to my house, I noticed some flapping wings over there. 3 dragons flying around like they own the place. I wanted to slay them, but the only problem was all I had was dragon bone arrows with me, and since I couldn't fire them with my bow, I had no weapon against these creatures. So I started sniping the red one when he flexed by flying sideways. Clearly a power move, so I went in for the melee. He entered my moat, probably peeing in it too, and I was not having it. This was clearly an act of war. I came right up to his face and slit it in half. I felt pretty victorious, but then I remembered there's 2 other dragons I still gotta kill, so I killed them as well. One was taking a bath in my lava river and probably peeing in there as well, or maybe the lava is dragon. I don't know. Either way, I stabbed him repeatedly until he died. I got all sorts of random trash from these idiots. Nothing useful as far as I could tell. Honestly, it could have been OP stuff here and I'd have no idea because these items just look like nothing to me. Oh yeah, I also used all 35 levels to repair my pickaxe. What a ripoff.
Remember all the obsidian I got 2 days prior? That's for a safety bunker for protection on day 90. Remember the sign in the house I found on day 1? That's what I was afraid of at this point. So I used over a stack of obsidian to make this 100% blast-proof bunker, which will keep me completely safe. Or at least, that's what I thought. Now that the bunker was finally completed, I needed a way to keep mobs from spawning inside because I don't want to just walk in there when there's mobs outside. Like I'm running away from mobs, go in there, boom, instantly get blown up by a creeper, so I gotta mob proof this bad boy. And I know you guys are thinking just put torches in there. No, that doesn't actually work because blood moons ignore lighting, so even if it's filled with torches every single block during a blood moon, mobs will still spawn in there, so I gotta do something else. I remember then I could use carpet. Well, okay, I could have used slabs, but honestly, slabs don't look that good. Carpet looks way better. But I needed wool, so I went out that evening and chopped down some wool mushrooms. On my way back that night, I stumbled across many different creatures, all different shapes and smells. Yeah, like look at this guy.
The heck is over there? And why is it coming at me at 900 miles per hour? Why is there a creeper riding on it? Oh! Oh!
Hey, halfway through and I'm still alive. No idea how I did it. And boom, carpet flooring. Isn't it beautiful? I wanted some more decorations, but unfortunately my armor stand just blended in with the entire wall, so I decided to go nostalgic and hang up my first ever armor set. After adding a few of my most precious items inside the bunker, I came to a sudden realization. One bunker can't save me from Herobrine, but you know what can? Turtle mode.
Guys, you know what the one thing my house is missing? The ability to go turtle mode. You know what turtle mode is? You flip a lever, lava everywhere. Just covers the entire outside of the house. So, that's what I'm gonna do now.
Like I said, I needed redstone, so I went mining for the rest of the day and almost caught 30 stacks.
That's diamond right there. I don't even want diamond, though. That's the only problem. I want redstone. There's some redstone, let's go.
Day 51, woke up, threw some eggs, and went out to collect string. I needed the string for dispensers for turtle mode, remember? I remembered a spider pit in the midst of Spooktown forests, and figured it was my best shot at getting the required string. I then shot arrows in the sky and tried to make them land on this lava idiot.
Check it! So close!
I missed. After like 10 minutes of wandering around the forest, I finally found the spider pit. I mean, like, the forest isn't even that big, but it took me so long just to find it. Anyway, I went in, chopped some webs, and came out. And suddenly it was night. I don't know what happened. Eventually, I made it back home around midnight, though, and I survived, so it's good. It's good. I made 10 bows on day 52 and then 10 dispensers. Pretty much all of day 52, actually, I spent working on turtle mode for my house.
I wish there was, like, ceiling redstone. Oh, that would be so great. It's gonna be a lot harder than I thought because there's not ceiling leadstone. Boom, they all go off. They all start spreading. Ha! Down they come. Oh poof! Oh poof! They're coming for me! I kind of forgot that they would do that. I don't have a solution to the problem. I think I'm a genius or something? I put buttons out here. Aha! I have a solution to the problem because I'm a genius. Just that goes off. No, the button gets deleted. Trapdoor will just get, it'll just flow right over. And it just destroyed my lever. Look at that, and I don't think trapdoors can burn either. I think we got a winner here, guys. Trapdoors.
Finally, I came up with a foolproof. Anyway, I came up with a plan to stop the lava from coming into my house. Trapdoors. Woke up on day 53 and instantly got to work. After a hard day's work of troubleshooting, I realized something more. I have great defense, turtle mode, and obsidian bunker, but I have no offense. It's time to add some offense, baby. Alright, time to craft up a buttload of dispensers. Except, nope, I was out of string, so that night I went back to the forest again. I spent tons of time trying to find the spider pit and got attacked by so many creatures along the way.
There's something chasing me? Oh, what the heck is that? Oh, it smacked me. He smacked me. I want to kill some spideys. Oh, what is that? Oh, holy cow. That was the biggest jump scare I've ever had in my life. Okay, why is something floating towards me and shooting poison bolts at me? It just blew up.
I spent the entire rest of the night in the spider pit fighting off these fiends, but by morning I had only amassed a total of 12 string. Talk about underwhelming. That was only enough for 4 dispensers, but what could I do? It was daytime now and spiders would no longer spawn. As soon as I logged in on day 54, I was greeted with a massive version of the little white dudes. Got an immortality gem from killing him though. I don't know what it does, but I guess I'll keep it.
Ooh, these are extremely bad for my sanity. I'm kind of curious. I'm gonna eat these spider eyes. I wanna see what happens when I go insane. I haven't seen much of that paranormal activity, if you know what I mean.
This was the stupidest idea I've ever had in my entire life, and I would later regret it immensely. And it wasn't just because it was spider eyes, but I was literally eating everything I could find to lower my sanity, and you guys do not want to know what happens when I lower my sanity. Anyway, I got back, farmed a little, and did some experimenting with some new traps. The next day, I was still trying to figure out the best way to conduct this trap when my stomach started growling, so I slaughtered a fat chunk of my chickens. Spent all day troubleshooting this next trap. Finally, on day 56, I decided on a design. A row of dispensers all along the outside of my house, which when I flip a lever, they would go full on AK-47 machine action gun mode and blow the heck out of any fool who even set foot onto my property. In order to make it fully automatic, I needed a piston, so I had to destroy my one and only gate because it had the only sticky piston in this entire universe. And I ran out of string again, so I went back to the spider pit. While murdering spiders, I found a giant moth creature floating around, and I killed it. It was pretty easy. Heck yeah, this thing dropped a killer knife. Why would a moth have a knife? Okay, I'm not gonna question it. Too bad it's not even close to the damage that my killer sword deals anyway. I left that place with half a stack of string. Oh man, I did something really dumb.
Oh yeah, guys, I actually just remembered. I'm pretty sure in the Soul Sand Valley, there's like skeleton versions of all the mobs that spawn. So, you know what I'm thinking, guys? A skeleton horse. That's what I need. I need a skeleton horse more than anything.
I thought that skeleton horses would spawn in the Soul Sand Valley, because skeleton, you know, it makes sense, right? And, well, I think it was the insanity getting to me, because I never found any. I spent like an hour it wasn't an hour, but I spent a long time looking in there. And then suddenly it was night, and it was too late. The mobs were coming out, and I'm just thankful it wasn't a blood moon. However, it's just as bad as a blood moon, because this night, the mobs have been modified permanently for every night after this one, including this one. I turned on a few more modes, and they spawn about 5 times as often. They do twice as much damage. They have 4 times as much health. They can run faster. Some of them can even fly now. They can build up to me. They can blow up walls with TNT. They have tools. They have all types of tools. They can dig. They can do whatever they want to get to me. The only block they cannot break is obsidian, so I'm gonna need a lot of that. Anyway, I still wanted Witherbone, so I went out mob fighting, which was honestly a pretty dumb idea since all the mobs just got majorly buffed. But right as I went out, I heard note blocks.
What the balls was that? I heard note blocks and then a sound.
Did you guys hear that? I have no idea what that was all about. Yeah, I never figured that one out. Well, I fought monsters all night long and never once got a single wither bone. I did get this specter goo stuff. I have no idea what it does. On the way back, I realized something about the lava river.
I have fire resistance permanently with this armor, so why do I always go around the lava river instead of just...
Still hadn't finished my ultimate trap because I needed arrows, so I gathered flint all day long. And that night, there was a blood moon. Check it, sniped a giant skeleton from over 50 blocks away and got an achievement right before the half-invisible giant spawned on my face.
What the heck are you?
I spent literally all of day 59 mining gravel for more flint. And a blood moon again. I forgot that with the new mob mutation, blood moons are super common now. And look at that, killed another invisible giant. I don't know why these guys are so common.
All right, it's day 60. Finally time to finish this trap. Oh snap, first I gotta murder this giant spider. Okay, now it's time. After about 1,000,000 hours, I got the trap to work. Super epic, it shoots arrows in literally every direction and there's no chance of hair running at me now, right? And plus turtle mode that will shoot flaming arrows that there's no way that anything will get me. Oh yeah, I also made a bunch of iron trapdoors for the base, because, I mean, look at that. It looks sick. I used all the flint to make almost 2 stacks of arrows. I spread it out into all of the dispensers on top of my base. There's no way mobs can get in here now. And, oh, wait, I just realized something. Mobs can spawn in the chicken pen, so I put carpet inside that way. Hopefully no mobs will spawn in there, because that would not be good. I needed a lot more arrows for the turret, so I turned gravel into flint for the rest of the day. Oh, hey, look at that. I got another rotten... Oh, brats, it didn't drop anything. I turned even more gravel to flint for more arrows. Look at this, I was just chilling with the chickens when a creeper decided to blow up my wall. The water clearly doesn't even work, I'm not sure why.
You just blew up the wall. The water doesn't work. Uh-oh.
So I ran to my house and activated turtle mode so the creepers wouldn't be able to breach the house as they did the wall. And look at that, my bird got killed by the creeper, and oh boy, another blood moon, of course it is. So the rest of the night I just fought off mobs from my base. Then I hid in the bunker because I was scared. Morning came, so I checked out the carnage. Massive hole from the creeper in the wall, look at that. Anyway, I started to work on a new trap, lava fountains. I'm not really sure how they're gonna work, but we'll find out. The next day I was still working on the traps, but I needed a ton of iron for lava buckets, so I went mining and I pretty much mined all day and all night. I started out day 65 by smelting a little iron. Look at that, I got some rotten eggs from the chickens, and so I threw it and boom, it hatched. And then, guys, you remember before when the bird died and I got the wither bones? Well, I wanted more wither bones, so I murdered the bird. Guys, it's fine. That bird only had a life for like 2 seconds, it's fine. I murdered it, and well, I didn't even get any dragon bones, so that was, that was great. So I filled all the buckets with lava, and then I slaughtered a ton of chickens, and look at that, lava fountain trap is operational. However, I still needed more molten cheese, so I got more dispensers so I could lava all around the entire house. The plan for the trap is when mobs breach the wall to murder my pants, I say, heck nah, brah, and flip it a lever, and bing bang boom, now they're burning in molten cheese sauce. Oh, and another blood moon, so I worked all night on the trap. Although there was a problem. Pigmen can spawn on top of these dispensers, and bigger problem, that means that creepers or other nasty creatures could easily get in here, which is not good. So I'm not sure how I'm going to solve that, because I can't put something on top of the dispenser, because that'll stop the lava from coming out, so... I left the house. I honestly don't really remember why, but look at that. Discovered snow. Also, this very strange thing happened. I went to where Herobrine was by accident, and he wasn't there. All the land was healed up. There was no destruction anywhere. It was as if, like, he was never there. I don't understand. And maybe it's like my insanity levels are going so crazy that that's why. But anyway, on my way back, I spotted a dragon, and he just killed itself in lava. There's a ton of mobs spawning, and I don't know why. Oh, it's a blood moon again. I sprinted back to the bunker because the only way I could possibly survive this situation is going in the bunker with turtle mode on and the lava fountain. As I was walking up to my base, suddenly Herobrine up and showed up right in my face. Look at that, he's on my base. I was completely confused. I have no clue how he got here. He must have teleported, but this explains why he wasn't at the other place.
I gotta get out of here. How is Herobrine at my house? He's burning it.
He's shredding my house.
I mean, look at that. He's straight up lasering my house and everything. He's destroying my entire base. This is it, guys. What am I supposed to do here? There's no hope left. All my stuff is as good as gone. It's shredded. He's destroying everything. All I have is what's in my inventory. I had to run. I ran straight through the lava river and just camped there for a little bit. And I can't stay at my house anymore. If only I was at my house when Herobrine came, because then I could have activated turtle mode. I could have done all the stuff, turned on the turrets, and I probably would have killed him. Maybe. But now I can't even get in there because he's guarding it. Also, why did I left the rock? Look at that. I was camping on the lava river and then I left it. I don't know why. That was the dumbest thing I've ever done. I started to form a plan to come back in the daytime to reclaim my home. Can't let a stupid moron like Herobrine take away my home from me like that. Also, look at that. Found myself in the obsidian flats and I almost died. And I found a bunch of new creatures I had never seen before. I fought for my life all night long. I found refuge on my old base, but it wasn't very safe and the mobs all followed me. Die. In the morning, I went to fight Herobrine. Time to reclaim my home. He summoned an angry pygmy that did way too much damage and almost killed me. And look at that, my armor started to break again, but I was able to repair it using XP again. Okay, new plan. My bow's breaking. I'm out of notch apples, so I decided not to kill him. I'm gonna sneak past him, run into my bunker, and snatch as many items as I can. This is gonna be like a drip Mission Impossible moment right here. I only have a few seconds that I can be down there before he blows it up, so I've gotta be fast. I potted up a speed potion, grabbed my diamonds and food, and a few other things, and ran. I also tried shooting him with the sun don't shine, but it had no effect on him. This guy's amazing. I activated turtle mode, flipped the lever for turret mode, but look at that, it didn't work. I think that he must have like jammed my dispensers or something because they would not fire, no matter how many times I flipped the lever. I was completely out of XP to repair my bow because of repairing my armor, so I went in for the melee, but it had zero effect. His toes are made of titanium or something. Anyway, look at that, I got super lucky that he didn't use his stomp ability to one-shot kill me or kick me hundreds of blocks away, and I was able to get him down to half health actually, but then my bow was just about to break, so I had to leave. And another blood moon, that's not good. I don't have a house. What can I do? I can't survive outside another night. So I ran past her, run right into the bunker again. So I just hid in the bunker all night long. And luckily, he never blew it up. That was really lucky while I was down there, because either I was outside running for my life or in there and I could die. And I didn't die. Morning came and I knew I had to leave once the obsidian was breached. It's gonna take him a little while, but I know that the time is coming before he breaks it. So I potted up again and went for it all. Risked everything. Barely made it out alive. Pigmen swarming me from all directions. I got laser spleefed into a massive pool of lava, but luckily I got fire res on my armor. I snuck around to the back of his back. Everything was over. It was very sad. The entire base destroyed in a fireball of death. No idea where to go from here, but I am lucky to be alive. Also, fortunately, I had some of my best materials on me at the moment. The chests inside are likely obliterated by now, so I had to retreat. There was nothing left I could do. Evening came and I made it to the forest. Very scared, tired, and alone. I made this script so dramatic. I had to make a new life here in the woods where he couldn't find me. I started right away with a house atop the hill, taking over that joint. I spent the rest of the night refurbishing the house. This house was very poorly constructed. The architect clearly had no sense of design. There was cobble on top of logs and planks on top of cobble. It's the worst build I've ever saw, honestly. Anyway, while refurbishing it, I ran out of cobble, so I mined up some more. Also, I had a lot of excess dark oak, so I used that for my roof, and I actually kind of like it. Also, I had to keep going up and down the mountain because I had to go down, mine some wood, come up, and then I'd run out of wood. So I went down, it just kept happening over and over again. The house was finally complete and looking good. I realized that I was actually a lot luckier than I had originally thought. When leaving the bunker right before it exploded, I must have accidentally still had eggs in my inventory. I was able to use these eggs to start a chicken farm. There was still hope and I was holding onto it tightly. I set up a wheat farm as well. Here's a little time lapse of it. Then I noticed something even more incredible. There were a few grass blocks right around the house that I had refurbished, so instantly I knew I needed this whole place to be covered in grass. Problem was, all the dirt was coarse dirt, and you can't grow grass on coarse dirt, but luckily, I have a massive brain, so I grabbed my hoe and tilled the coarse dirt into regular dirt. This took a lot longer than I thought it would. In fact, I broke so many stone hoes that I started making iron ones instead. I wanted some more livestock besides the chickens, because the more of the same food I eat, the more insane I get with this mod. So I went out and right away, I found the first abandoned house that I found on day one. I looked around a bit, saw the cryptic sign again. Still not really sure what's coming on day 90 because Herobrine has already arrived, so I don't really know what could be worse than that, but I'm scared. I was out a little too late and got caught in the dark, was forced to use a torch as a lantern, but eventually I found my way back around midnight and I was fine. I was still looking for livestock to populate my home. I also found another white dude and my aim went full noob mode. Like, look at this, I cannot hit him, but eventually I killed him and look at that. Spectre bread? I have no idea. Like, what is spectre bread? It says it's immensely bad for my sanity, so you guys know
I was about to eat it. Also, at this point, I just remembered that there's actually a sanity measuring device, but the only ingredient I was missing was glass. But the problem is, there's no sand anywhere in this world, so I had previously given up hope. However, I just realized there's glass in this window right here. Oh, wait, never mind, I'm an idiot. You need silk touch to get that, and I don't have bookshelves. Okay, it's impossible. Never mind. I did grab some wool from a mushroom for carpet so I could easily leave my farm without the animals getting out. I only had one single bucket of water, and without glass, it's impossible to make infinite water source with only one bucket. And there was a singular spot in this entire nightmare where there was water. Problem was, it was very, very close to where Herobrine is. But I needed these farms more than anything, otherwise I would die out here, so I went anyway. Either I'd die from starvation or risk my life to get water, so... On my way out, suddenly 10 bajillion mobs spawned out of nowhere, so I ran back to my house as quickly as possible.
I don't know if my house will be safe. I don't know if it's a good idea to go there. They might just blow it up. Holy cow, I'm gonna die. Holy moly. Oh, they're here too. Oh, the zombies blowing up everything. Come on. I'm pillaring. Okay. Nope, that didn't work. Oh, man. Oh, no.
Yep, that's right, guys. I was definitely all a dream where I died. My insanity was getting to me, and I dreamt myself dying. Also, these guys out here, they just happened to be here as well. Oh, and the craters all around are, illusions. Yep, I'm gonna blame everything that just happened on my insanity levels going haywire. I can't believe my chickens all committed death on their own. Had nothing to do with my dream, and was not real life at all, and it was a dream. No, completely. No further questions, period. Now I didn't have chickens, which meant I didn't have a food source, which meant this is literally the hardest part of this challenge so far. I was toast. That's what I'm trying to say. Oh, and on top of all of that, I accidentally broke my infinity power four bow trying to shoot one of these stupid little poison idiots. Which is, this is horrible. I mean, I don't even have my power bow anymore. There was hope, however. A very tiny, slim sliver of it. I had two eggs.
One? Oh no. Here we go, guys. No!
No! Oh man. Neither of the eggs hatched. My farm was destroyed. I had hardly any food left, just enough to last me a few more days. This was not looking up at all. Although I still had some seeds, so I fixed up as much of the farm as I could, but it was not very much. Definitely not enough to sustain me longer than a few days, maybe a week. My bow was my only way of killing Herobrine because my sword did no damage to him at all.
However, I had no arrows left, but I know where there were a ton of arrows, at my half-eaten bunker right under Herobrine. I got like 4 stacks in there, but I needed a way to get in and out without being seen. Or at least maybe if I went super, super fast. Also, I discovered something about this so-called enchanted armor. Every time it breaks, it auto-repairs itself using my XP levels. I don't know what that's about, but I mean, I'll take it. I was determined to find sheep, or cows, or pigs, or basically anything that I could farm out of. Actually, no, I couldn't make a farm out of pigs because I didn't have carrots. Anyway, I went out with a plan to never come back until I had found 2 farmable livestock. I was out way too late again, but this time I got trapped in a blood moon, so I did the only rational thing a genius boy like me could do. I dug down to the ground and hid from all the mobs.
It's pitch black, I'm likely to be eaten by a Grue? Alright, I placed down a torch.
What the heck was that thing? A Grue? I don't even know, like, what is that? I'm just glad it never got me. I never found out what that was, though.
What is this? What is this? What?
What was that as well? I'm so confused. I think it must have been a giant zombie that was partially invisible or something. Pretty sure that comes from my sanity mod installed, but I don't know. All I know for sure is that I'm glad it didn't kill me. Anyway, I think I found some diamonds and some stuff while down there. I don't really remember though, because diamonds aren't that important. I was tired of trying to find my way out of the cave, so on day 74, I just decided to dig out. I spent all day searching for animals and never found a thing. My farms were slowly running dry, and in a few days they would stop yielding enough crops completely, so I decided to make more farms around my base. But I needed more water still, because last time I went to get water, a blood moon rose and I nearly died just trying to get back. Or, well, I did die, but it was a dream or whatever stupid excuse I came up with. I found water, grabbed it, and waddled back to my home to make more farms. The sun rose and I had a very important plan on my mind. Just kidding, I was only tilling the ground to make it grassier around these parts. I also chopped down some trees or something like that. It really wasn't that interesting. My bread was running out quickly, and even though I made more farms, they weren't quite ready for harvesting yet. But then I remembered the fossil that I saw on day 1. I ran back to it as quickly as humanly possible and got about 3 stacks of bone blocks for bone meal. And for the rest of day 77, I was just growing and planting my crops. Oh man, day 78 was a beautiful day. Happiest day of my life. Sheep! Look at that, seriously. I thought all hope was lost, but there's sheep, sheep, and more sheep. There's so many. Well, okay, actually there was just 2, I think. But hey, that's good enough for me. It actually took me an entire day, but I was able to bring these morons all the way up this mountain and into a pen. Man, I was so happy about this. I might actually be able to survive the rest of this. I had an idea on day 79, which would theoretically keep the mobs out. A very simple idea, but hopefully a very effective idea. I dug a moat. Well, Okay, not really a moat, more of a wall, really. I just removed one layer of dirt around my base so that mobs can't get up. However, I think I was kind of an idiot here because there are mobs like zombies which can tunnel and build up. Also, mobs that can fly, so this couldn't possibly stop any of those.
Day 80, I kept working on the aesthetics of my base. It was finally time right here and right now. No longer would I let myself have no range attacks on these idiotic creatures. Time to infiltrate my own base from behind Herobrine's backside and steal the arrows. The plan is simple. Get a visual on my base, then sneak behind Herobrine's back while he's occupied lasering the ground, then enter the base and head to the top floor. After that, retrieve the arrows from the dispensers used for the turtle turret, and while there, go down to the bunker to see if there's anything else useful I can grab. Finally, eat the heck out of that joint before he realizes what happened. Whew, alrighty boys, we did it. Got 4 stacks of arrows from that heist. Not bad, not bad at all. Oh, I also messed around with this chicken for the rest of the evening. Yeah, it was weird. I don't really know what I was doing. Alright, the base was looking fine, and I had a new addition, which was much needed for this bad boy. A watchtower. That's right, idiots. I started work on the big old fat watchtower to watch everything going on around me. This is gonna be the most beautiful, incredible, useful, effective, and beautiful, again, thing you've ever seen in the history of... Oh, wow, yeah, actually... That looks horrible. I gotta remake that. For some reason, I thought cobblestone would make it look better, but nope, didn't work out too well. I think the problem is the head, not the tower. Okay, there we go. That looks a lot better. Man, it took me like 3 days to build that thing because of how many times I had to take it down. However, the tower was still far from complete. Well, no, actually, that's a lie. It was pretty close, but it just needed some redstone in it. I had big plans for this big old watchtower, including lava, but first I needed more redstone. Now, there was a ton of it at my base where Herobrine was, but I mean, I'm not gonna sneak back in there and get out live, right? Honestly, I thought for sure he would have exploded my base by now, but I think because the chunks haven't been loaded, he hasn't gotten the chance. Anyway, I sneaked in there, got the redstone, and sprinted it out of there. I then filled a bunch of buckets with lava for my next trap. I made it back to my base and instantly got to work. Took me a solid day and a half, but eventually I got the lava trap working. I know I've been calling it a trap, but really it's just like a safety precaution. All it does is dispense lava around the tower's base to kill anything trying to breach it. Guys, I'm a total moron. I mean, I guess you already knew that, but how many times am I gonna build wood next to lava before I realize the wood is just gonna burn? So I decided to replace it with obsidian. Unfortunately, I don't have any obsidian, so I just used what I did have, bone blocks. Normally I would have just gone and mined some obby, but my pick was literally on like 30 durability, but I thought, you know what, I might as well just mine as much as I can. So I got my pickaxe all the way to 1 durability before stopping. I started replacing the bones with obsidian, but I didn't have quite enough to finish the whole thing. And another blood moon. Oh boy, here we go. Whole bunch of idiots started running for my tower. However, they had no idea I had a lava trap. And boom, get molten cheese to the face, morons. Oh rats, I forgot pigmen are immune to lava. Well, that sucks. Look at that! The mob somehow breached my impeccable defense and made it into the watchtower. There were all sorts of flying dudes going all around me trying to decapitate me. Oh man, look at this. This zombie started building up to me. They literally had cobblestone and TNT and knew how to use it. I poured lava down the tower middle because I didn't want those clowns to get up here and get me. Looking back, that was kind of a dumb decision because some of the mobs don't take damage from lava and they could just swim up it and get to me even easier. Nah. The moon was finally setting. The night is almost over. I jumped down to assess the damage and it was not looking great. I really wish I had more obby so I could just make the entire watchtower out of it. Anyway, I killed the remaining numbnuts and tried to clean it up a little bit. And the night of day 88, it's another blood moon. That's 2 in a row. How is this even possible? I started lava casting cobblestone all around my watchtower. To be honest, I have no clue why. It doesn't really deter mobs at all. In fact, it was probably my dumbest decision here to lava cast because I got knocked off by a flying nerd and I barely escaped right there. I was lucky the night was still young and most of the mobs hadn't spawned yet. And like a world-class idiot, for whatever reason, I went back to lava casting. What is wrong with me? Oh yeah, then this happened.
Holy cow, it's a dragon! I killed it!
And right after that, I was going to lava cast some more, and look at this zombie literally built up and spleefed me with TNT. Luckily, I was able to get away, but like, dang. Look at the damage to my watchtower after the zombies exploded that.
Die! This is insane! There's nothing- Ah! What the-
Even with fixing the watchtower every single day, I can't survive this because they just destroy it again every single night.
What? This is an army! Ah!
Slowly it was becoming daytime. The night was finally over. The fact that these days kept getting tougher is not good for me. I almost died last night in another net like this and I'm sure to be dead. Since there was a plethora of idiots below, the only way I could safely make it to my humble abode was to pull out another tactic I learned from Sun Tzu. When pinned to a tower, you must build with much power. Now, this can be interpreted many ways, but I didn't have any time, so I built a bridge. Also, I used up all my arrows, so I had no other choice. Anyway, I made it to my hut, grabbed arrows, and after that, I used up another stack of arrows just cleaning up these
tools. They do call me Janitor Joe for a reason. I knew my only way of surviving this anymore was to slay Herobrine, since he was in charge of all these mobs. I needed to kill him before the mobs evolve and became so powerful that it's literally impossible to kill them. At this point, my mind came to a sudden dark realization. It's day 89. I had no clue what was coming, only that it was something extremely dark and extremely scary. Okay, that was a little over the top. If I was gonna kill Herobrine, I had to do it now, so I started preparing. It was a peaceful morning. I woke up, bred the sheep a little, and noticed a giant meteor that had blown up my farm. Wait, what? A giant meteor blew up my... Oh, no. This is the prophecy being fulfilled, isn't it? Meteors everywhere. Last night must have been an insane meteor shower. Luckily, none hit my house and killed me while I was asleep, but this one here got really close. He must have called these meteors down. This was it, guys. I was fed up. I started setting up traps. I lined the outside of my house with a row of dispensers. If he comes here, he will die so fast it won't even know what happened. Now, that was really just a safety precaution to keep me alive while I prepare. I only had about a stack and a half of arrows, so I got to work gathering flint and feathers in order to make more. The biggest problem I was facing, however, was that all my chickens had been slaughtered, so I didn't have very many feathers left for arrows. So day 90 I spent gathering arrows. Now day 91 I'm gonna spend planning my very calculated attack on this moron. Yo, check out my house. A meteor crushed right into it and absolutely shredded the structure. That's okay though, I had moved on. More important matters are on my mind. My original thought was to place a load of dispensers on the volcano side and shoot at Herobrine, but I decided that would be too hard to aim, so I came up with a new plan. I was gonna build up above this fool and rain down arrows right on top of his ugly face. It was getting late, so I started traveling back to my house when I noticed this meteor had red sand around it. This gave me two very interesting ideas. First was that I could finally get my sanity measuring device, but the second idea was TNT. I could use the dispensers to rain down TNT right on top of him. I woke up and instantly crafted up my sanity measuring device. It says my sanity was damaged. I spent most of day 92 gathering red sand from all the crash sites. Using the gunpowder that I had accumulated over the last 92 days, I was able to craft 34 TNT. All of day 93, I just cleaned up the watchtower and the huge mess which surrounded it. I went out on day 94 to get more sand because, I mean, come on guys. Really think I could kill Herobrine with a simple 34 TNT? I was out in the middle of the day, seriously, the middle of the day, when all of a sudden, the light was ripped from the sky and night was upon me.
Oh! What the heck just happened?
And then this happened.
Why does it say the harvester?
A harvester. Guys, I have no idea what this is, but it can't be good news. I just hope he isn't here to harvest my soul or my crops. I can't live without my precious wheat.
Oh, I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die.
I ran away as I almost died. I knew I had to chug my potions.
I'm drinking these potions. Because I don't know what's going on.
I've been saving these potions since the day I found them, and I knew this is why I was given these pots. So I went in for the mono-e-mono and slayed that idiot like he was breakfast.
What the heck is this? What is that? I killed it. Whatever it was, it's dead.
So easy. Actually, it's just literally just a two-shot. And check it out. He dropped a Sith.
Scythe.
Pretty quickly, I learned that this thing isn't only a deadly weapon to whomever yields it, but also clears out a huge area of crops. The next day, I tested out my brand new Sith on my farm, and bro, this thing is quite epic. I mean, honestly, not that useful since crops are pretty easy to break already, but still, this thing is pretty fun to use. Oh yeah, I also tried to explode this pig. And it did nothing happened. I tried out my Sith as a weapon, and it's like a better sweeping edge sword. Since my armor was breaking, I made a new set of diamond armor just in case this stuff breaks before I murder the brine. Day 96, I spent trying to improve the safety around my base by clearing out a lot of the dirt. I spent most of day 97 gathering obsidian for my new armor since my last set was breaking pretty fast. I had to add the obby to my armor in order to make it OP. Alright guys, no more messing around, no more stalling. Today is the day I take him out once and for all. No more rematches, this is it for all the models. I've taken out phase 1, phase 2, but now it's time to take out the final phase. I made my way up the weird tower thingy and filled the dispensers.
Oh, there they go! There it goes! I am extremely depressed. How did it did nothing. Did it do anything to him?
Is he immune to TNT blasts or something? How did that massive group of TNT do literally nothing to this big man? I realized I was no longer directly above him since he had moved a little bit to the side, so I had to do some repositioning. I filled the dispensers with arrows and they were raining down hard on this fellow. Look at his health bar just dropping.
Oh yeah, I saw his, oh yeah, his health is dropping. How is it, it's already out of arrows.
But then I ran out of arrows.
Holy cow! I forgot about that with beds.
At this point, I realized I was running out of time. It's day 99 and I was out of arrows and there was no way I could get back to my base during this night. I decided on a brand new tactic, drowning. Yep,
I was gonna kill this giant with water. I basically spent all night trying to drown him, and I was never able to do it, just pushed him around a lot. Okay guys, day 100. If I don't kill him now, I will be forever stuck in this nightmare. It's now or never. I ran back to my base, grabbed my extra arrows, and started firing arrows nonstop on this idiot. I stayed far enough away where he couldn't see me, but I could just barely hit him with the arrows. His health was dropping fast.
Come on, he's so close. Yes, just a few more shots and he's dead. Come on, one more. Last one. Yes! We did it!
He's dead. The world has finally become peaceful. No way.
Fully enchanted. Oh, let's put it on.
And guys, I can fly now. This is incredible. Okay. Sweet. Thank you guys for watching and being so patient between uploads. It's been like 3 months since my last one. I'm gonna try to do them more often now. Also, there's the merch. Okay, bye.